Today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC2209 with sensorless homing on the BigTree Tech version 2.0. Now there's a few things you need to know about this, such as where the stepper ports are located for your stepper drivers. Now this is a TMC2209. I have cooling fins on top. And obviously the enable pin's located in the bottom left-hand corner. And the other enable pins are here, 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 and then obviously over in here. But for sensorless homing, we're gonna have to add a 2mm jumper, which is smaller than the normal one that I'm pointing to right now. And I'll show you the difference a little bit later when we actually configure it, but we need to figure out where the jumper positions go. So I'm going to show you a couple of things that involve the stepper first so you have an understanding of what that looks like. So if we were to look over on the actual desktop on my computer, you'd see that I have the data sheet pulled up for this. And this will be relevant if you want to compute your root mean square for your stepper, along with the stepper for your NEMA 17 or other type of stepper. So as you can see, the main reason that I'm gonna show you how to do this today is because of Stealth Chop. And essentially it's silent motor operation, so it's very quiet. There are other things that you can set, such as spread cycle, but I'm not going to show you that in this tutorial. We're just going to default to the Stealth Chop mode. The other thing I do need to show you is that Marlin, when it first came out, they had the wrong MOSFET on the board for the SKR version 2. And it's located right here. To make sure that you have the correct version, it's gonna say on it, on top, HY1904. So make sure that it says it on this before you install these steppers, otherwise you'll cook your steppers. So the next thing that I wanna show you is the actual manual, but I'll show you the pinouts again. The enable pin is located here, 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 and here. So that's going to be relevant in a moment, but for UART mode, the jumper needs to be placed right here. And then if you're using the actual sensorless homing, there's going to be a jumper that you have to place here. I've already placed it on the X stepper, but I've left it off of the Y, and I'll zoom in a second to show you that on the actual board. So let's go back over to the actual workbench. And on the workbench, I'm going to pop out these jumpers so we can configure them. So I'm gonna place it next to the other one so you can actually see the difference. So it's a 2mm size. If you're interested in knowing where to find it, it's pretty easy to find on Amazon. But if you want, I'll place Amazon affiliate links in the description to make this a little bit easier. And just keep in mind that no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial. So let me get this last one out. There we go. So we're going to place it like we saw in the actual manual, which is right here. And then I'm going to zoom in a moment, but I already have the jumper in place down in here. And that's the jumper. The reason I'm not doing it in the video is because it takes multiple tries when I have the board a distance of about 2 feet away from me. Whereas if I'm up close, I can drop it in with a pair of needle nose pliers. So I'm gonna zoom in and I'm gonna show you these pins because they're very tiny down in here. There's two pins that need to be jumped with a 2mm jumper. So what we're gonna do now is we're actually going to install the stepper. So I'm going to lift this up and show you that it's got red on one side, black on the other, and then has these pins. So obviously you're going to match it to the pattern that you see right here. So I'm going to push that on, and just keep in mind that when you're running these steppers, it's best to have a controller fan on your actual fins to keep them cool. Now, I did this in my DRV 8825 video for the SKR, so I'll include a link to my playlist so you can find that. And that'll be in the description of the video tutorial. So, next thing that we need to do is actually configure the USB real quick. And we have to take out the SD drive and place it in our USB converter because we can't send over a file at the moment on this board. So I'm going to plug this into the computer. You can hear a beep that it's connecting from the previous connection, but I'm also going to set up the power. Currently, it's unplugged. So I've already marked these with positive and negative. So the red is actually voltage on this, and the one unmarked is actually ground. So I'm using 12 volts for my power supply. This may vary. In my case, I'm not going to show the adjustment for the voltage for StealthChop in this tutorial, but it's located in the advanced configuration and it's already defaulted to 12 when you download and extract the Marlin firmware. So the other thing I need to talk about is the actual jumper over here. It's set for direct power, which means that only power can flash when it's on that. If we were to move it over to the other two pins, then we could use 5 volts to power the board. So the reason that I tell you that is you want to keep it on power when you're actually doing steps. And the reason for that is because it will affect your steps if you're on USB power. So let me plug this in for the X on the NEMA stepper. And let's configure the firmware. So on the computer, we're going to go over to VS Code. And inside VS Code, what we're going to have to do is actually open the extracted firmware. So if you click on the Explorer, I'll show you what happens with this. So let me just configure it so you can see better. You're going to click on Explorer, then Open Folder. Then you're going to go to your Downloads folder, your first Marlin folder, your second Marlin folder, and then Select Folder. That'll open up everything you need. Once that is actually opened, what we're going to do is we have to set our actual default environment. So this involves paying attention to certain steps in this because they've changed the way they do the INIs because they're now in these folders. So you're going to have to go to the individual INI or file, pardon me in this case, and select what you have. So I'll show you how to figure that out now. So if you go over here and you click on the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then go to boards.h and search on SKR underscore V2, you'll see there's two boards. The second board's the one you want, the Rev B. That's the one with the correct MOSFET. So we're gonna copy this, then we're gonna minimize this folder, but we'll note which actual stepper, or excuse me, not stepper, processor or MCU we're using. So you can see it's an STM32F4. That'll correspond to something in the INI folder over here. So let's set the other things and then go back and do that in a moment. So I'm going to go over to the configuration file. So it's configuration.h, and I'm going to search on motherboard. I'm going to paste what we just copied over our ramps. I'm going to set the serial port to -1, and then I'm going to scroll down or search on A4988. This will bring us to our steppers. So currently it's default to the A4988. We're going to change that to the TMC 2209. So I'm going to copy that, I'm going to paste it, and then I'm going to scroll down a little bit further and show you something else real quick. We have default access steps per unit. This is going to be very relevant. So currently it's defaulted to 80, which is usually a belt-driven system. So this may vary from your system to others. So it depends upon your printer and the configuration. So we're going to go over to configuration advanced.h for a second. And I have to show you this other piece because they're tied together. So I'm going to search on 800. It's going to be a couple of searches. And this will bring us to our X current. This is where I was talking about root mean square and using the data sheet to compute it. Normally 800 is a pretty good value to work with. Some people do 750. It's your taste and preference depending upon what your data sheet says. So that can be variable. That's why I'm not covering it. So the thing that I was talking about with 80 over here for the default, if you were to double the actual resolution to 160, so it'd be 1/32nd of a step instead of 1/16th, you have to change the 16 here to 32. If you were going to change it to 64th of a step, it would be 320. And let me add that comma back in. And then over here, this would be 64. And that's how you count up. You can go as high as 256, but I don't recommend it. I guess the max would probably be about 1/64th, but there is obviously 128 in between. So that's the first thing I wanted to show you. The other thing I wanted to show you, if you're not doing sensorless homing, please do not use the TMC2209 as your stepper. But if you're using a stepper that has an inverted direction, or you want to invert the direction, on configuration.h you can search for invert. And down here you'll see that you can actually change the actual direction of your stepper. The same thing can be accomplished with a DuPont connector on your board if you reverse it 180 degrees. So now that we've got that covered, we do need to set some other things up. So I'm going to search on TMC underscore debug. This is kind of important because we want to see what's going on. You can turn this off in the future if you don't want to use it. But I have to remove the comment first for the monitor driver status. And then I got to find the second one. And this is for our actual debug command, which is the M122 G code. So I'm going to hit the control slash to remove the comment. Then I'm going to go back up for a second and search on sensorless homing. And in order to enable it, we have to hit the control button and slash again. And then down here, this part will become enabled. Now, the 8 right here is actually for SPI, or serial peripheral interface for communication. So we're using the TMC2209, so we have to set our value. And the optimal value I have found is 125 for sensitivity. So now that we've got that set, we can go back over to the platform.io.ini and we have to set up the actual default environment. So I'm going to click on the .pio folder and I have to point this out. This is the previous build that took place. So I'm going to clean this out real quick. Sorry for the tangent that I was just explaining, but I'm going to go to the .pio over here. We have this, so we're going to have to go to the INI folder. So I need to minimize some stuff so we can see. And we're going to look for the STM32F4, which is right here. So this has a bunch of different configurations in it. So we're going to search on SKR underscore V. And that didn't work, so we're going to try SKR underscore 2. And that brings us to BigTree underscore SKR underscore 2 for our environment. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to go back to the platform IO, highlight the Mega 2560, and paste our environment. So now we can actually build. So we're going to click the build button, which is a series of compiles. And keep in mind, if it does fail while you're compiling, try clicking it a second time because sometimes things build out of order. If that's the case, it may work the second time you build. If it breaks on the third time, find the very first error that you encounter, it'll probably be in red as it's scrolling by, and fix that one first. Other errors are usually related to a cascade of errors that occur from the first. So this is going to be done in just a second, but it's populating the build folder as we speak. And as you can see, we're going to have our firmware.bin in here in just a moment. So to actually load this, I need to right click and I need to say reveal in File Explorer. So inside File Explorer, we have our firmware.bin and then we have our boot drive. In this case, it's got firmware.cur in all capital letters. What that file is firmware.bin that's loaded previously, and it's automatically renamed to firmware.cur for current. A lot of people have debated that it's a cursor type file, which is true, but if you rename it back to firmware.bin, it will reload. So you could probably use it for multiple systems. So that's something to keep in mind. It's not a cursor file. So I'm going to go back over here, right click on the firmware.bin, and I'm going to send it to the boot drive. So now it's on the boot drive. We're going to go back over to the workbench. So on the workbench, I'm going to remove the drive. I'm going to populate it in here on the board. Then I'm going to connect the USB and make sure that it's on direct power because that's why it's not lighting up the board because of the jumper. And then I'm going to plug it in. So once I plug it in, it's energized, so you don't want to touch the board. So at this point, I'm going to go over to Pronterface and I'm actually going to try to connect to it. So inside Pronterface, right now it says I'm on COM port 1, which is not our COM port. So I'll show you how to find that real quick. So if we go over and we type Device Manager, it'll bring up the Device Manager, and over here you can check your COM port, which is COM port 4. So I'm going to change this to a 4 if it's not already in the list, which you can edit, but currently it is. And it's at 250,000 bits per second. So I'm going to connect. It says connecting, printer is now online. So I'm going to test the actual stepper with the M122 to make sure we configured it correctly. And currently it says it's okay. So what I'm going to do now is actually move the stepper. Excuse me. So I'm going to move it 10 and see what happens. Notice how it moves in the opposite direction I thought it would. Now I'm going to move it in the other direction. And when it moves in the opposite direction, that was what I was talking about for invert. But now let's try home. So it's homing in a direction opposite of what I thought, but it works. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time. And for all the people that have signed up on Patreon or donated via PayPal, thank you very much. It goes to giving you more tutorials in the future.